I don't even know what to say. This album dropped out of nowhere. Not much advance notice. I just heard somebody playing Bodak Yellow as they were driving by. We about to kill that noise real quick. J. Cole's got a new album. K.O.D. I don't really know what to say. But I know I'm going to have a lot to talk about. I don't want to talk for too long during this. So, for once, let's just get into the shits. I want the music to speak for itself. And then I'll respond. J. Cole. Kids on drugs. It's a pandemic. King overdose. He's not one to judge. He's doing the same thing. Kill our demons. I'm assuming that's the Kill Edward feature on here. I guess J. Cole is trying to beat himself. Track number one, intro. That's creative. Trapped inside myself. Oh, don't start with this shit.
This frightens me. I'm in pain.
That's not true. Some babies cry just because they're fucking assholes.
Choose wisely. Choose wisely.
Very soothing intro track. I like how in this track we kind of start off, you know, with what the theme of the album is going to be. As he says, there are many ways to deal with this pain, so choose wisely. Basically saying you can choose to deal with this in a certain way, but most people choose to deal with it through drugs. Basically saying people who are addicted to these substances generally are in pain in some kind of way. KOD.
This is what you call a flip. 10 keys from a car to grip. Hit me from his mama whip. KOD, he hard as shit.
KOD, he hard as shit.
This is what you call a flip. 10 keys from a car to grip. Hit me from him. I didn't want to reply. The number one question is how. How does it feel?
I've heard this part already.
How about I don't? How about you just get the fuck on my dick?
This sounds so much better in high quality.
Sit the Titanic, don't tiptoe around it. My shit is gigantic. It's because the fuck in Atlantic, I'm lit.
Bitch!
I'm much agavist, I convince activist that they should pay me. If practice made perfect, I'm Pattis' baby. If practice made perfect, I'm Pattis' baby. My niggas sell crack like it's back in the 80s. No young nigga, but old ladies, he don't give a fuck if them crackers gon' hang him. Bitches be asking why I have you been lately.
Man.
I stacked a few M's like my last name was Shady. My life is too crazy, no acting
can
play me. My life
is too crazy, no acting can play me.
This is what
shady.
You call a flip. 10 keys from a car to break.
Okay, cool. That stacked a few M's line like I was shady. That's fucking funny. I like how Cole references that this is the character's introduction to drugs by being in a club and then they start shooting up. So they like, you know, he's obviously talking about like, I don't know, like he's obviously talking about heroin. Like they start shooting up. Then he says, my homie got the pharmaceuticals. I can feel it through my blood. I'm working it and I'm numbing the pain. So We're getting the theme here, and I like that Cole is sticking to the concept so far, so let's keep going. After he takes the drugs, then we see that there's like this mental imbalance now, because he's obviously crazy, he doesn't care about anything anymore, he's addicted at this point. He start robbing old ladies, doing shit in the open, not really caring about his surroundings, not caring if the crackers can hang him, obviously not caring about police. Track number three, Photograph.
In love to photograph, I don't even know your name.
Some old Cole.
You don't get caught up in rumors. You don't be talking about who fucking who. And I notice the way you maneuver. All the sublime. Your type is harder to find. You can turn water to wine. Yeah. You can turn water to wine. Don't think I'm built for this shit. Yeah. Too busy thinking what if. Yeah.
Okay.
But I can't come up with nothing. No. But I can't come up with nothing.
Oh.
I put it off for a day.
All right. So for this track, I get where he's going. You know, like talking about the social media love atmosphere and how you can like fall or be infatuated with someone through their online presence. Knowing nothing about them, Cole has convinced himself that this chick is this goddess. Not knowing nothing about her, that's what Cole has convinced himself of. And he's actually giving himself anxiety about approaching her, not face to face, but approaching her online. I don't know how this track is going to tie into the rest of the album, but hey, track was okay. I like the instrumental in the background a lot. I just think that Cole could have been a little bit more. And I guess I kind of like the point of the track. I mean, it is a little vague, but I feel like that also defines what the track means in a way, because it is a vague fucking track. Like, all you know about this chick is from her photos, and you're describing it. And this song is very vague at the same time. Track number four, The Cutoff, featuring Kill Edward.
I've been a couple times stuck in my ways, so I keep on falling down.
Give me a high, let me float. I'm a club, coming down, put me down, chillin' out.
I'm so mixed, because I know this dark version of Cole. I know the dark voice thing, it's just kind of corny, but it sounds good right here. It sounds good for this hook. Also, these lines in the beginning of this song are so fucking beautiful. He said, I know heaven is a mind state, and I've been a couple times. This is where the drugs made him feel. This is where they He felt like he was in heaven because of the drugs. That's how high he got. Then he says, I'm on my come down now. And you can see, like, as he's describing his come down, he's a little bit more depressed.
Eventually, but right now that's hard for me. I'm dreaming violent. I can't tolerate disloyalty. I pray that on that day you slip and say something. I never fantasize about murder because I'm still sane. But I can't seem to fight this urge to make you feel pain. I know that vengeance is the Lord's and it's not they was using me. My heart is big. I want to give too much. And usually from you, I remember that. It was blurry for a while, but now it's coming back. Coming back.
I don't know about this singing voice, right? I don't know about this. This shit is really getting addicting right now. That hook really grew on me while this track was playing. I still think the voice, the dark voice thing is a little corny, but I do like the way it sounds on this track. And I'm guessing Cole is talking to himself. I mean, this Kill Edward is just a dark version of Cole, so I'm guessing Cole's talking to himself as he's talking about all the things that this dark version of himself wants to lend him. He's clearly been using a different version of himself to talk to these women. I would think that this would be about a friend, but knowing that this is about killing his demons, I feel like Cole is just talking about himself. I love how when he's talking about, I'm not about the murder because I'm sane, but I feel the urge to make you feel this pain. But how do you punish yourself for something and you're you? How do you give yourself a punishment for something you did that you're disappointed in? How do you shame yourself or hurt yourself for that? Because at one point he also says, I pray on that day you slip and say something. If these are people that Cole isn't even seeing anymore, how can they slip and say something to him? It's as if whatever Cole is talking about is still close to him and he's praying that it says something so he can knock it back out. If you cut some people off, you're not going to see them anymore. So how can this person say something to you if they never see you? That's what makes me think that this is a demon. That's what makes me think that this is someone who's still right next to Cole. Track number 5, At The Moment.
On my soul.
Count it up.
Yes.
Second is paper, it's sort of habitual. I blow the residual and fucking your bitch like it's part of my ritual. Pull my bag, thinking God like it's biblical. I know it's gonna solve every problem I have. I bought all the remember, and all of a sudden I'm so good at math. Count it up.
Yo. I tell people that all the time, like from my school days, they know I was horrible with math. I barely passed math every single class. When we got to calculus, I barely passed it. Then when we grew up and got a little bit older and like money is involved, I can literally give you any, as long as it has to do with money, I am a mathematician. But if it has nothing to do with money, I suck at math. And what he's trying to say is when it's important, that's when I'm good. That's when this mathematical information is useful to me and applies to me. Is when the money is involved. Other than that, I don't give a
fuck. Count it up.
Big kills, it mixed well. I'm only counting big bills.
Proceed with caution. I heard if you chase it, it only results in a hole in your heart. Fuck it, I take the whole cake and I won't leave a pause. She don't need a garment. She horny from all of the money we counting. Count it up.
One of the beginning lines of this verse is like, I heard if you chase it, it only results in a hole in your heart. And then he says it's only an organ. Just describing how nothing comes before what he wants. Like, he's extremely selfish right now. And I love how he's talking about, like, the effects of drugs in this track. When he says, like, they can't sit still. Don't give a fuck if it kills and mix well. What did he say in this one line? Because he said, the money give me a hard on or something like that. Hold up.
But money, you give me a hard on is typical. I wanted it physical. $1 million, I count up in intervals.
But when he said that, the money, I wanted in physical, for how all these like rappers, they feel the need to show off their revenue. So it can only be shown to people in physical form. They can't get it in a bank account. They can't keep it in a car. They can't keep it in some other account. They have to show it off to the world where it's not safe. I'm liking it right now. Track number 6, Motivate.
Superman is.
This sounds like a sample.
Watch this.
Spill my medicine inside a double cup. Double up my cream, now that's a double stop.
Know the lobby
this
on
shit
bumps. Sean Kempy, keep that phone.
Motivate.
I feel like taking a PJ.
Oh, it's Junior Mafia.
Weekdays, speak English, right. But the money is something that they can complain day. And I got bread like I'm Green Day. I just spit, blap.
Motivate.
I like how this track ties into like the previous track, because on this track, it's basically like the same kind of hook. Last track is Count It Up. This track is Motivate. So it's like the money is his motivation. It seems like he's looking for a reason to justify what it is that he's doing right now. Like he's trying to figure out a way to make sense of it to himself. And if it involves money, then that's his motivation. But so far, like I said, Go's doing pretty much what I want. He's sticking to the concept so far. Track number 7, Kevin's Heart.
But my phone be blowing up, temptations on my line. I stare at the screen.
You know you about to get this man Kevin Hart in trouble with his wife if he played this around her. You don't just bring this shit back up. They left it for dead, and you gonna bring it back up. Like,
me and Sandy at once. Somebody. I got the earth and the blunt. Run from the pain, sip lane, smoke tree up. When I'm in your town, press pound, hit me up. When I'm in your town, press pound, hit me up. Like I'm sleep, knowing damn well I be up. Monkey on my back, and I walk 100 miles. Guilt make a nigga feel fake when he smile. Love get confused in the mind of a child. I have my cake and another cake too. Even if the baker don't bake like you.
This is great.
Damn. I done did so much that when you see, you might go blind.
He had to say that shit twice because I missed it the first time. Oh, the track is over? My bad. We all know what this track is about. Kevin Hart and his situation. And I like how J. Cole is like calling himself fake, which is really, I mean, like this whole thing is a reference to Kevin Hart. So I can't really say it's J. Cole calling himself fake. It's low-key calling Kevin fake for going against who he truly is. But if you haven't really faced yourself, I guess this is who you truly are in a way. Definitely a great jazzy track, and Cole is giving some good honest lyrics here. I like this. Track number 8, Brackets.
I would go home, I
who
say,
is
Dad,
this? Richard Pryor?
I won't get that much money, man. You know what he say? You's a lying motherfucker.
Niggas hating on me, I ain't used to that. Know a couple people won't shoot for that. I say no, chill, it ain't no need for that.
Yo. Niggas come. See, Cole really is somewhat relatable sometimes, man. Sometimes you got a couple homies and they're just like, you know, they see some slick shit happen and it might happen in front of you, but you're trying to be better than you used to be, so you overlook the situation and then they still want to act on it. You got to tell them to chill out, like, it ain't that serious. Not yet. I don't need you for that.
I just sit back on cool and watch my paper stack and trip off how much bread them crackers take from that.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah. I pay so much in taxes.
First motherfucking $1 million check, nigga. I'm got them lit. Uncle Sam and shit. What's up, uncle? Yup. Hell yeah, I tell you that check. How much was it though? 30%. Half, nigga, you crazy. Crazy. Bitch, you crazy. That's funny. Taxes shit don't make sense. Where do my dollars go? You see, lately I ain't been convinced. But my niggas barely graduate. They ain't got the tools. Maybe cause the tax dollars that I make sure I sing is spent. I don't look like them. And the curriculum be tricking them. Them dollars I spend.
My God.
The pen that write history, they always see the white adjacent. Do I even have a say about where it's going? Too fucking slow. If I'm giving y'all this hard-earned bread, I wanna know. Congressman, I've never seen dictate where my money goes. So right now, he got two on the way. Still sleep on covers in his mama house. She can't take.
I can't, dude. Like, this dude is. He will not fucking stop. Give me a break. Go into the hook or something. Give me a bridge. Give me a chorus. You can't keep spitting like this. I need fucking almond milk now.
Sunglasses, she remembered that she gotta file her taxes. Damn. Whoa.
Now J. Cole has addressed taxes in the past in his verse with Kendrick Lamar on Black Friday. He's mentioned it on 2014 Forest Hills Drive. A couple of times he's mentioned it, but this is the first time I feel like he's actually gone into a peel back a layer of what it feels like. Because when you finally, when you really start making some money out here, like when you get to maybe like $75,000, maybe at least $100,000 a year that you make, the taxes they make you pay are fucking atrocious. They are atrocious. And I get that paying taxes is the way to help fund the country that you stay in. So I don't have a problem really paying taxes. The issue I have is not having a say in who gets hired in the police force, who gets hired at schools, what the kids are learning at those schools. Anything that's tax funded, you have no say in. But they want you to pay it every couple weeks when you get paid, every time you make a little bit of extra side money in other ventures. Everywhere you make money, you gotta pay taxes on. I love the way J. Cole handled the phone call. Like, he says, hey, it's Unc. My Unc is calling. But it's Uncle Sam saying, hey, we heard you got that bread. Because they get notifications when you get money. They know when you get your money. So they calling you to check up and say, hey, you owe us some money. Well, owe you some money for what? I worked 50, 60 hours last week. I did this and that. I just got a bonus. I just worked my ass off doing this extra side thing so I could, you know, start my own business. Fuck you mean I owe you half? You don't get a... Man, this is a great track. This is probably my favorite track on here. This right here might be my favorite. Then people want to tell me to vote? Like, get the fuck out of my face, man. Talking about vote. If I don't get a say, if my tax dollars don't get me a say, you really think they're going to give me a say when it comes to the voting booth? Man, kill yourself. Track number 9, Once an Addict.
Lost in a cloud of marijuana, young Carolina nigga, fish out of water. Stepdaddy just had a daughter with another woman. Mama cursing me out, depression such a villainous state. I used to stay out later on purpose, of seeing my hero on ground zero. Tears flow, I out, green blow, love and happiness. Oh, I wish that I could say the right word. You better pray to God you never get your heart crushed. I shake my head in frustration, head 1 a.m. and my mama dialing my phone. I know she intoxicated and soon as high that I'm on comes crashing down. She lit talking drunk. How she do this to herself? Hate how she slurring her words. Sounding so fucking absurd. This is for real. Well, maybe things get better with time. Out of fear, I won't be free.
One thing I will say about this album so far is J. Cole needs to get some features or something like that, because I don't feel like he needs to. I don't know. He addressed this on KOD, but as far as vocally for singing, I don't think J. Cole needs to do all of his own singing. I don't. Some of these tracks would be so much more beautiful if he added a singer, a vocalist, something. You don't even have to be popular. You ain't got to get something trendy. Just somebody that sounds good to mix it up and add a different feeling to the track other than just your own voice. This track is fucking beautiful. Not only is Cole saying that my mother unintentionally passed depression on to me because she refused to address it. A lot of people don't understand, like, when you're in a certain community and you don't really have time to address certain things. Picture it like this. You have a community of people that don't make that much money. So obviously, they probably don't have health insurance. If you have health insurance, you'll probably be able to address a doctor or a therapist or something like that to say, I'm not feeling good right now and I don't know why. Black people, especially black people in the hood, really refuse to admit or address depression. They do not. It's a huge issue. But because they have other priorities in their location, they refuse to address these things. So it manifests, it turns into a learning habit, their kids learn it, the kids try to help them out of it. But as you see in this exact same fucking track, J. Cole says, my mom called me and ruined my high. J. Cole unintentionally, and I don't know if he's dropping from his own perspective, unintentionally became a habit or a victim of his environment by saying, oh, I'm high right now. Why am I smoking drugs? I'm in pain. This is some issues that I haven't addressed. He doesn't even fucking know it yet. Track number 10, Friends, featuring Kill Edward. Oh my God. Look at this. Yo, that's crazy. My mom is calling me right now. She's about to ruin my high. No, you can, what's up?
I'm aggravated without it. My Saturdays are without it. My Saturdays are the loudest, flowing strong. Some niggas.
He just said my Saturdays are without it. Without it, I have Saturdays. He also said my Saturdays are my loudest days. That's when I smoke the most.
Some niggas graduated to powder, I dabbled later. Feeling like the only one that made it, and I hate it for my niggas cause they ain't got ambition. Missing. Blame it on Trump shit, blame it on Clinton. Blame it on trap music and the politicians. But they only got 12 slots on the Pistons. Blame it on the rain, Milli Vanilli with the discus. Type of shit that normally would call for therapy. But you know just how it go in our community.
Exactly.
That shit inside, it don't matter how hard it be.
This is exactly what the fuck I just said.
Blow you, so I know you still keep a lot of shit in. You running from yourself and you buying product again. I know you say it helps and no, I'm not trying to offend. And then you get lost in the wind. And I done seen the combo take niggas off the deep end. Demons, they bound to catch up one day. I'd rather see you stand up and face them than run away. I understand this message is not the coolest to say. But if meditate.
I don't think it's gonna be a hot take to say that this is J. Cole's best project. And I'm not saying that because, oh my God, it's just the freshest one. I'm paying attention to what he's saying. Like, his lyrics in this album far exceed anything he's done before. I'm sorry, they just have, to me. These aren't as catchy. They aren't as melodically pleasing. Lyrically, as a rapper, J. Cole is the best he's ever been right now. That is a fact. And he's literally talking about what I just talked about, so I don't even need to explain the track. That's awesome. I mean, it's hard to talk about depression and anxiety and things like this and and trying to prevent people from using the drugs in combination with you being depressed. But J. Cole having his answer saying, I got a reason, you know, I got a way for you. Maybe you should meditate instead of medicate. That's still another way people, even meditation, some people don't find the solution, you know, in that they need some kind of outlet or some kind of activity. And sometimes meditation doesn't even work for certain people. So it's hard to say that this is the way when we get to the end of this track that J. Cole's saying, I got a way for you, meditate. This is going to do it. Like, it might not do it still. But the lyrics in this track, I appreciate so much. I just don't agree with the ending because it's he's coming across as if this is the way when it may not be for a lot of people still. So I just think it would have probably been better received if he had no solution at all, because it's hard. It's hard. It's hard to recommend one thing for millions of people. It's hard. Last track, window. Well, this isn't the last track. Windowpane outro, track number 11. I got a 4-minute outro. Well, last one was about 7 minutes, so never mind.
If I ever wanted, what's to hit them bitches, holla back. Get some money, plus respect, and now look, I got all of that. Killed a man and made my mama cry. All I want to do is touch a platinum plaque and celebrate. All I want to do is keep my niggas out the yellow tape. Have I sacrificed for fame? My occupation's on my plane. Thought that I could change it all if I had changed. They be listening, but it's clear to me they did not hear a thing. Bang in the villa, I always thought that shit was strange. How you claim blood or cuz when that was just an LA thing. I don't mean no disrespect. Yeah. Shooting up with granny live. Blow, blow, his granny duck.
Stop saying blow.
Just because your dick can spray semen, it don't mean that you're ready to let go of your childish ways. The results of dead out with all you went through. A bullet hit your cousin in temple while he was with. If you was my sister, then I would kiss you and tell you that I'm sorry for the pain you had to live.
I guess window pane is J. Cole, like, I'm trying to look at the track name and see if that makes sense. Like, windowpane is kind of like J. Cole looking from the inside out. Like, he's looking at other people's perspective and saying it's windowpane because it's something that he really can't do anything about. Like, you're not my sister, so I can't help you. Just like I'm trying to recommend. I see all this stuff going on around me, but I can't do anything about it, really. I can't really directly stop it or directly inflict a change. I agree with him on a lot of what he's saying, though. Especially the people repping Blood and Crip when that's an LA thing. I always thought that. I'm like, how are you out here with this bullshit? You really look fucking silly and stupid claiming to be a Blood in Detroit or a Crip. You look dumb. And here, you don't have to be in a gang. People have individual gangs in their head. Like, they do things by themselves. Final track, 1985. Intro to the fall off.
Five, we wasn't supposed to get past 25. Joke's on you, motherfucker, we alive. You gotta give a boy a chance to grow some. Everybody talking like they know something these days. Nick, I respect the struggle, but you all fronting these days. Man, they barely older.
I get that line right there. J. Cole was saying, like, all y'all judging these, like, little young rappers or whatever, trying to act woke or whatever, but at the same time, if you were in their position, you easily would have took that paycheck. And I get what he's saying. Like, he says that there's beauty in the struggle, but I can see a bunch of fakers. Like, all y'all that are saying this right now would easily be in their position if you could.
Come here, little man, let me talk with you. See if I can paint for you the large picture. I got some good advice, never quit torn. Cause that's the way we eat here in this rap game.
That's good advice.
I'm fucking with your funky little rap name. I must say, by your songs, I'm an impressed hey. But I love to see a black man get paid.
Yep.
And plus you having fun and I respect that. But have you ever thought about your impact? These white kids love that you don't give a fuck. Cause that's exactly what's expected when your skin black. They wanna see you tatted from your face to your heels. And somewhere deep down, fuck it, I gotta keep it real. They wanna be black and think your song is how it feels. So when you turn up, you see them turning.
Cole, man. He's giving it. That line. Whoa, man. How do I say this respectfully? Don't try to tutor me on how to be black because you listen to rap music. I hear it's a lot of young Caucasian people out there. And I fuck with everyone. But don't try to tutor me or give me advice on what goes on in the black kid. I know what goes on. You don't have to tell me. I don't need you to tell me. Out of everyone in the world, you are the last person I need to tell me about what's going on in my racial demographic, in my area. And a lot of them think because they listen to rap music, you know what it means to be black. You don't know it all. You have no fucking idea at all. Shut the fuck. You cannot give me any advice. But I love you though. But be quiet.
Dude, got better shit to do. You could have bought a crib with all that bread and chewed them blue. When they them kids is listening, gon' grow up. And yep. Get too old for that shit that made you blow up. Now you scrambling and hoping to get hot again. But you forgot you only pop cause you was riding trends. I'm hoping for your sake that you ain't dumb as you look. But if it's really true, I'll be around forever cause my skills is tip top. To any amateur niggas that wanna get rocked, just remember what I told you when your shit flop. In 5 years you gon' be on Love and Hip Hop.
And that's the album. That track was hilarious. So that was J. Cole's album KOD and How Am I Feeling on It. Man, this is a, I don't think it's a stretch, like I said, at all to say that this is J. Cole's best work. I like most of what he's released in the past, but I don't think any of it has ever really been such a straightforward message that wasn't just so cringy for the most part. I mean, I like this one more so because it has a theme to it. Maybe it's not the deepest album conceptually, but it does have a theme in it, and it fully sticks to that, in my opinion. I know people will say that about Forest Hills Drive. I don't understand why Forest Hills Drive is such a classic to you mofos. Like, it's a good J. Cole album, but that's all it is to me. It's just a good album. This album, I feel, he's doing three things in this body of work. Because at one point in the track, Friends, where he's talking about, or is telling his peers out there and the people who are going through this depression not to deal with it through drugs, but he's saying he's not trying to insult them or judge them. I think when you look at the album cover and you see these kids on drugs, and then you see J. Cole calling himself King Overdosed, and then you also hear it's Kill Your Demons or Kill Our Demons, it's tackling all three of these in one body of work, because essentially Cole is trying to say that he's not in the position to judge the kids that are on drugs. He's not in the position to tell them exactly what to do or tell them how horrible they are or how wrong they are. This whole album isn't spent judging those kids. It's not spent judging or trying to be pretentious. So J. Cole being the king, especially on the album cover, being King Overdosed, the king is saying to the kids on drugs, I'm not in a position to judge you because I'm still killing my own demons. That's what the track, or that's what the cover art is supposed to be. And in a way, it's almost like J. Cole is leading these into stepping stones, saying you can start out as a kid on drugs, mixed with your demons, you're gonna end up a king overdosed unless you kill your demons. Like, that's what I feel like. I feel like even though he's saying that he's the one that's on that pedestal, he's saying anyone else could easily be here in this position. If you are a kid on drugs and you don't kill your demons, you could be a king overdosed. That's what I feel like. Now, as for the tracks individually on this project and the way I feel J. Cole tackles the subjects that he's discussing, I do like that most of this album is thematic. However, I don't really feel like J. Cole really had that much closure with his demon. It felt like he, on one track, acknowledges it and acknowledges the problem and the pain of it and the struggle that he has going back and forth with it. But I don't really hear the acknowledgement of this demon from Cole. I feel like the demon, or Kill Edward, comes in at whatever point in the track that he wants to, and J. Cole really doesn't acknowledge it. I know there are fans out there that are probably gonna say, oh, it was supposed to be like that, because you don't recognize when you're doing something wrong a lot. But J. Cole made such a conscious effort to include a feature that is the darker version of himself, and he doesn't really confront that version of himself on any of the tracks. He just kind of subtly hints at it. I obviously understand that J. Cole is a lyricist, and he's not going to include a bunch of mumble rap kind of thematic or trendy stuff in his music. He's not going to have a bunch of trap beats on here and everything like that. But I do still think for J. Cole, the production was interesting enough beyond what it was, at least on his previous album. Track 12 isn't really supposed to be included on this album because it's an intro to another project that J. Cole, I guess, is working on, or maybe released sometime in the future, obviously. So this track list really ends at track number 11. Including track number 12 in this project isn't really a good thing to do, because Windowpane is the last point of this project that we get addressing the state of the world, like the drug state of the world. That's why J. Cole at the end realizes, I got window pane, meaning I want to help, but I can't. There's only so much I can do. I like how J. Cole does do everything in these songs, but at the same time, I don't really like, or one of the things that I don't really like is, like I said, his want to be the, I'm not trying to say he wants to be the center of attention that bad, but I feel like he forgets how musically pleasing some of these tracks could be with the addition of another voice. I think the dark version of his voice is just really corny to me. I really do. Like, I don't think it adds that much, and I think it's a very skeletal way to introduce the demon aspect of this. Like, all of them have to be demonic. Like, the voice has to be dark. Like, J. Cole, I can do it too, right? All right, listen, this is the regular me.
This is the dark me.
It's the same shit. And when you're in the dark voice, you're not saying anything that poignant. You think the dark voice would know a little bit more about J. Cole, be a little bit more deceptive, be a little bit more deceiving, be a little bit more powerful, as he's saying that he has such a strong presence over this track. It's supposed to have some sort of dominion. It doesn't seem to have really much power at all. And again, I know people are gonna say, oh, well, that's the point, is to say you're stronger than you really think you are. No, that wasn't the point of this album. I think there are a good amount of tracks here that J. Cole does go off lyrically, but some of them just don't fit the concept. Like on the tax bracket track, I like how this track talks about the struggle with paying taxes and not having a say in your environment, but sometimes it feels like he's just including Get Me to a Higher Place or including the drug aspect just to make it seem as if this album is cohesive when the track may not be about what the album is. It's the same thing on Photograph. Like, I like that track in saying that women could also be your demons, but a high emphasis on this project is drugs. So I'm really kind of eliminating these other temptations from being something that can affect the poignancy of this album. I feel the same way about Kevin's Heart. Like the track, J. Cole does well lyrically, and I like, you know, the concept of it being a reference to Kevin Hart and his cheating scandal, but does it relate strongly to the album? No. KOD, The Cutoff, At the Moment, Motivate, Once an Addict, Friends, and Windowpane all relate to the album. They all relate to the concept. And some of the beats on here actually do bump. There are some tracks on here where the beats are a little bit more boring, I guess you could say. Some of them aren't really that intriguing or interesting. They kind of follow a very simple bass start and stop formula. I noticed that about KOD. It kind of does the same thing. You know, even though I really do like the track, I felt like the bass could have been a lot harder hitting. And I know why J. Cole doesn't have these like super extravagant beats, because he wants to display his lyricism as the forefront on this album. But that being one of the bigger problems with some of his previous projects, I feel there are a lot of people that won't be able to engage with this by default. And maybe that's not the demographic he's trying to reach out to, but he should also understand that's the demographic that probably need this the most. I definitely think if you are a J. Cole hater, it may open you up to the possibility that this dude might be a good rapper. But as far as making the best music, I don't think Cole is there yet. I guess my bigger issue with this album, even though I love it lyrically and I like what Cole is discussing, is just a discussion. It's not really a solution to the problem. He says a solution at one point is meditation, but after talking about all this for so long, the most we come up with is to sit down and breathe. It makes me feel like he just threw this out there just to talk about it. You know, and I get it, that's the point, is, you know, these are things that he feels aren't really discussed in that community, and at least to discuss it, maybe that would help. But I can't really see it being a positive to form your whole album around this concept and not have a solution, and not have a, it seems as if you're just as confused as the people you're preaching to. As far as the lyrics are concerned, I like pretty much all of these tracks. Conceptually, what it's shooting for kind of misses to me. Individually, these tracks being so minimal as far as the production is concerned, I question how many people are going to come back to some of these tracks and listen to them all the way through. That lack of production takes away a lot of replay value for a lot of this album, even though I like a lot of these tracks lyrically. I like the advice he gives to young rappers at the end of this album, as it's an intro to another project, because this is a subject that J. Cole actually seems to have the answers to, as opposed to majority of the track list before it. But the album just comes off as like more of a, this is what could happen if you follow this pattern. I would describe this project as a problem without a solution. That's what I'm feeling on it. Thank you guys for watching the video. J. Cole, KOD. Enjoyed a lot of it, but hey, I'm going to give it some more listens, obviously. I'll let you know if my thoughts change on anything. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Let me know what some of these tracks meant to you in the comment section down below. And I'll see you next time. I'm out. Peace.